It's a new day and the stars are right. Wake up, Lil Cthulhu, it's time to play. Lil Cthulhu lives in the magic city of Relay with all his friends. Relay is usually under the big blue ocean, but when the stars are right, Relay rises and the great old ones can come to Earth and play. Uh-oh, Lil Cthulhu is hungry after his long nap. What does he do? He eats his followers. They love Cthulhu and want to be eaten. Their souls make his tummy happy. Lil Cthulhu is best friends with Dagon and all the other deep ones. They plan to go to Innsmouth to visit all the nice fish people there. The fish people chant praises. Chant, chant, chant. Hear them chant. Yah, Dagon. Yah, Cthulhu. But Cthulhu goes to Egypt to see Lil Narlathotep. He's called the Crawling Chaos, because he can't walk yet. They have fun reading the Necronomicon. Oops, Cthulhu accidentally summons Yog-Sothoth, master of the gates between worlds. He's mad because Lil Cthulhu woke him up. Yog-Sothoth sends him to Yugoth. Yugoth is where the Migo live. They are like big bees with glowing heads. But Lil Cthulhu is lost. How can he get back home? He meets Hastur the Unspeakable. Cthulhu doesn't like him because he's smelly. But Hastur lets him borrow his bio-key to help him get home. Maybe he's not so bad after all, Lil Cthulhu thinks. He is flying to the center of ultimate chaos. He sees Azathoth, the blind idiot god and master of all creation and destruction, who writhes endlessly to the pounding of vile drums and the blasphemous whine of thin reeds. It's too loud for Lil Cthulhu. Finally, they get back home to Earth. Lil Cthulhu wants to play more, but the stars are changing. Relay is sinking again and it's time to go to bed. Lil Cthulhu is tired from his exciting day and goes back to sleep in his house. Maybe next time the stars will be right longer and he can have even more fun. And even now he sleeps in his house under the sea, dreaming his dark designs outside of space and time until the stars are right once more. Good night, Lil Cthulhu.